Welcome to Module 4, Work Energy Approach for Particles. So before we talk about the work energy approach for particles, let's do a very quick recap of what we discussed in previous module, which was about kinetics of particles. So in the previous module, we had a particle, which we treated as a system, and there were certain forces applied on it, let's say F1, F2, and so on. You could write some of these forces equal to the mass of the particle times its acceleration. So maybe there was some information given to you about the summation of these forces, and you could compute the acceleration, from which you could maybe compute velocity as a change over time. Or maybe you were given the acceleration and there were some parts of the forces that were not known to you, and you could determine those. You could also solve this problem for a system of particles, where maybe multiple forces were acting on multiple particles and there were multiple accelerations, and maybe certain forces were known to you but certain accelerations were not known. But as long as you had required number of equations to solve for exact number of unknowns, you could solve the problem. Now there are certain kinds of problems where you will find that it's much easier to use an approach which doesn't involve writing full-fledged vector equations of this sort. So in two dimension, this leads to two scalar equations. In three dimension, this leads to three scalar equations, because you can resolve this vector equation along different coordinate axes, or if you use the curvilinear coordinate system, you still have a frame. So it's a tangent normal system or a polar coordinate system, you still have a frame over there. So there are some problems where actually you're not asked to compute acceleration, okay? You have to relate forces with the displacement and the velocity. So the three quantities, forces, velocity, and the displacement, are going to be related, okay? So that you can see that there's no time information here and there's no acceleration being asked for. And the problem typically has a particle or a system that is displaced over certain distance. So for example, I have a block, and this block is resting on ground, and I apply a force F on it, okay? And at this instance, let's say its velocity is V1. After a while, under this constant application of the force, the particle has moved by a distance X, and its velocity at this instant is V2. So now you can see that you have forces, you have the displacement, and you have the change in velocity, and you have to relate these three quantities along with maybe some other quantities as well, but these are the three primary quantities that you're trying to relate with each other. In this situation, it turns out that you can use a much simpler approach, which we call work energy approach. So some of the problems, so the kinds of problems that you may have to solve, maybe that you know the forces applied, you know the displacement, and you know the initial velocity, and you have to compute the final velocity. Okay, or maybe the velocities are known to you and the displacement is known, but you don't know what the forces are. So in a problem where you're not asked for acceleration and you have to relate these three primary quantities, you will find that using work energy approach, which actually leads to a scalar equation, unlike this one where you have a vector equation, can give you solutions much faster. Okay, so whenever you can, try to use the work energy approach.